subscribe to a Sign Design Elements subscription. That will be a price of $14.99, so $15 or 15 euros a month. And then you will get 100 free, downloads each month. So you can log in with your cloud account. Okay, and you'll see I have still 95 downloads left, as I have a subscription to the FlexiSign Design Elements website. Okay, in this database you will find vector files, you can find bitmap files, but as well, very easy in today's webinar, you will have the template finder for cars and trucks. So in this case, in our example, we'll need a Mercedes-Benz and the Vito. You can search for model year, model type. So let's say 2020, and you will see the 2020 Mercedes Vito example. I think in my case, I have already downloaded the 2018 template, so very easy. You can here press download and it will start downloading a zip file, a zip folder, of course. Okay, so I will import the template. So I go to my Flexi and I select file, import, go to the downloaded zip folder, and I will import the Illustrator artwork. So in this case, it will, the template will be an Illustrator file, but no problem for Flexi. We can definitely import this one. So import, import text as path, and I'll import the file. What we see now is the scale of the file is 1x20. If we want to work on a one-to-one scale in Flexi, we can use the Design Central to maximize the artwork. So multiply by 20, multiply by 20 in the Design Central and press Enter. Make sure the proportional checkbox is checked. And if I scroll out, zoom out, we'll see it's maximized. And then we can use the template in a one-to-one scale. So right mouse click and I ungroup the file. And I will delete the elements which I don't need. So today we will only want the sides and the back. Okay. As well, I want my artboard a bit bigger than the file, so I will make my artboard 9 meters by 4 meters, for example, or 6 meters, like so, and the car template will fit in my artboards. Okay, is this clear for you all? Are there questions about Sign Design Elements, about the subscription, for example, or the import of the file? Everything's clear. All right, so we can go on. So we'll see here a very basic logo for my brand, Keep It Simple. So how can we recreate this very easily? In Flexi, we can try to redraw this one. So we take the circle shape, like so. We make the circle 50 by 50, for example. We go to step and repeat. Okay. Step and repeat, and we set in the Design Central Copies horizontally and two vertically with a spacing of the object which we're using, so 50 centimeters. We press OK, and then the only thing is we will need to copy another one here. We can center this one by selecting the corners, select the middle object and press the both centers alignment like so. Okay, the only thing is we will need to make this part here of the K. So it should be a modern K, of course, the logo. How can we do this? Let's see. You can copy this, rotate this 45 degrees by double clicking, and then we take a guideline. We can align the guideline as well. Another one. We can align it as well. We take a rectangle. We draw the rectangle. Should be 50 high as well. Oh, not proportional. Align those and combine with the weld tool. Okay. And now we can delete the guidelines, of course. Rotate this one. Align this one. Same for this. Okay. Like so, and we weld all everything together, weld, and we have a vectorized K. Like so. So if you press Ctrl F, you will see the outlines of your artboard. So Ctrl F, you will see all the outlines of your objects in your artboard, or you can also press the fill mode here in the toolbar. Okay. So we need as well the circle of the logo. So we take the oval shape and we center this with Ctrl 5 in the circle. Press Ctrl M, or you could take the exclude one, let's say Ctrl M, so you have your logo authorized. Now I will import the color, so that would be a SAI purple color. So import the SAI logo. Okay, I unmask, right mouse click, and I'll use the eyedropper tool to make my logo purple as well. So now we have our nice logo. We add text next to it. We take the text tool, type some text, very small, so we have to make it bigger, keep it simple. And those letters need to be all in uppercase, so we can go to text, case, uppercase, like so. Center both objects. Okay. And maybe we can change as well the font to a Myriad font. And this one to a semi-bold, for example. Like so. So now we have our vectorized logo. What we will have to do is we want to put this logo on the car templates. So I'll make a copy of our logo by control and drag. We will take the car templates, this one here. Okay. And we will fit the logo onto the car. Something like this. Okay. Here we can see as well in the Design Central the dimensions of the logo, of course. If we want to cut this out of purple vinyl, make sure we will cut this, the whole object. So in this case, we can, for example, to show the customer or to make a preview of the application, we can mask the logo. So we can see how it will be applicated. So in this case, we will copy the exact size we need. Okay. And then we will mask the logo in the car plate, car template. So we will select the outside of the car. Okay, and we will order it to the front or make a copy by right mouse click, copy, and then paste over. Select the logo, right mouse click, and mask. So now you'll see the logo is masked in the car. Okay. First of all, what I forgot to say is, in this case, it's better to work with layers, of course. So we can go back to the design editor. Design editor. So we have an overview of the layers. So this is your first step you will need to do. So I want to copy my artwork like so, Control X, and make a new layer here, new layer. And I'll paste over the objects. So now I have two layers, the first layer with the template and a second layer with the artwork. I can rename as well the layers. So this is the template and layer two is the design. You can also change the selection color. So in this case for the design, I want green as selection color. You'll see if I select the letters now, you'll see a green line around my objects. Template is good, red. And as well, you can deselect cuttable. So you can select the cuttable icon. Meaning the template is not cuttable at the moment. So if we send something to the cutter, everything will be sent except the layer which is uncuttable right now. Okay, so we're working in the design layer. Here, keep it simple. We just need the text as well on the side of the car, like so. Okay. So everything what I'm doing is 100% matching the size of the vinyl, of course. So meaning my text in real life will be as well 67 centimeters by 40 centimeters. This is very useful in Flexi, of course, if you can work in a one-to-one scale. Okay. As well, we need the information on the side of the car. So we need some icons, and I have a icon as a bitmap format, so we can easily vectorize the phone icon. We go to bitmap vectorize auto trace, select the objects you want to trace, delete the background bitmap, of course, and you'll see you have the phone icon in a vector type. Of course, we want to center this in circle objects, smaller, like so, Control M. Okay, next we will make the mail icon, but I do not have a bitmap example or a vector example, so we can just recreate the email, the mailbox icon. So what we have to do is a rectangle, let's say 70 by, so we draw it, 70 by 50, like so, and with some rounded corners, like so. Okay, and then we'll need to recreate the envelope. So what we can do is a square, 70 by 70, for example. Rotate this one, like so, align. The only thing is we'll need an outline, so effects, outline, set an outline distance, like so, and press apply. Then we separate by right mouse click, separate outline, select both objects and press Control M. The only thing now is we have to exclude the objects from each other. So we can go to Weld and select the last one here. Okay, so now we can remove the objects we do not need. And see, we have a nice envelope logo vectorized. So we copy the circle, uncompound, group this, make this white, center. Like so. Very easy. Any questions? Are there any questions? Okay, perfect. Hopefully everything is clear. Okay, and for the next icon, we need the website logo. So we will have to redraw a globe, which is easy in Flexi. So we copy this one. We make a circle. 100 by 100, for example. Okay. We make an outline of 5 centimeters. Okay. At mouse click, separate. Control M. Okay. We make a new circle. Center this one with a height of 100. Okay, again, we make a outline of 5 centimeters. Okay, separate, Control M. Then we'll need 2 lines of 5 centimeter height. like so, group them together and align in the center. We select everything together and we select the weld button, and you will have a nice globe, center both objects, make this one white, so now you have your three icons. Of course we will need some text next to it, so copy some text. Okay. Member, for example, copy and drag, align, okay, keep it simple at keepitsimple.com, and the website, for example, okay. Like so. We group this together, make it smaller, and we can fit this on a one-to-one scale on our car. Like so. Voila. Okay. So we have three objects to apply on the side of our car. So we have the circle with the logo, we have the text, and we have the information. For the text, of course, we can add a extra rectangle. If we cut this out, we can just measure the top of the window and align the text very easily. Same for the information here. Okay, we group all objects together. So this is a very important step. So group all your objects together. Group like so. And I'll copy this one here. And I'll copy this one here, for example. Okay, so now we want to cut out our objects. First of all, we check if the lines, so with Control F, are okay. For the white objects, we are not able to see the preview as the outlines are white, of course. So what we can do is select all objects, press D from Denmark, select selection only, fill, we select the white color, okay, and for example make it green. So in this case you will see the outlines perfect. Okay, next is we select the objects we need to direct cut, and we go to the cut plot tab. In this case I have a Summa S2-160 setup in the production manager. So I press cut plot tab. Okay. Like so. Make sure you have the selection only button here, otherwise it will select everything which is cuttable in the file. And a very easy feature in 19 is the nest option here. So if you press nest, you will see automatically the grouped objects are nested together. So make sure you have keep groups and texts selected. Otherwise, it will automatically nest the objects separately. So select keep groups and texts. You can set as well spacing between the files, like so. We need two copies, of course, because we need to apply the back and the front, the left side and the right side. So we make two copies, and you'll see automatically the two copies are nested together as well. As you have the nested option selected. Okay, so we can center this one in the middle of our final. You can of course pull the size of the media which is in the cutter. Go to the options tab. And here you will have the option to add a wheat border or some wheat lines, which can make your life a bit easier. So in this case, we will select some horizontal split lines, and you will see, I'll make this one a bit bigger. You will see here, you will have some split lines, which will be as well cutted. So this is very easy for the person who will have to cut out the objects or to weed out the objects. As well, you can right mouse click and add the split lines manually. So you can add split lines where you want by right mouse clicking the preview. You can also add a wheat border, for example, and this will cut out a wheat border around all the objects. So around the job, it will add an extra wheat border. Of course, all the... Okay, I have a question from Lee. When we are at Q&A, can you please go over again how you change the color of the white objects when in fill mode? Yes, of course. So in this case, my Summa is set up with some strategies from the default job properties. If you want to use the cut settings of the machine, you can right double click and select none. Apply, okay. If we select use same driver options for all colors, all the cut strategies will change to none, and it will for all the colors which are visible in the preview, it will use the same strategy, of course. So in this case, we have a nested direct to vinyl cut shop. In the advanced tab, you will have some other extra cut features. So in the advanced cut tab, you can set some default cut settings, which can be used as like security or safety checkboxes. So for example, you will have the auto weld option selected. So the auto weld means that all the overlapping text objects are welded together automatically. So in case the globe wasn't welded very well, then the auto weld would weld it now. So it doesn't cut out all the separate objects. Of course, you will have a optimized cutting order option. This means if you check this cutting order, it will cut by 25 centimeters fields. This can be useful, but for this type of jobs, I would not recommend to select this one. This is a very important one, the eliminate line segment overlap. This means if you have a file, mostly a DXF file, for example, with overlapping lines, the cutter will only cut once. So this is like a safety box to make sure you only cut once on a on overlapping lines. So for example, if you have two objects on the same position overlapping each other, it will only cut the line once. Okay. So those are some security checkboxes, and then if you're happy with the result, you can select send now and send the job to the cutter and it will start cutting. Please always check the strategies which you're using, of course. You can also set a preset if you save the preset. And let's say car vinyl, you will have a predefined preset for cutting as well. Of course, it will keep the settings, so the copies, the nesting, and so on. Okay. So this is a very basic example, but I think I showed some very nice tips. So I think we can go over to the question of Lee. Go over again how you change the color of the white objects when in fill mode. So if I select some objects and press D, the D from Denmark, of we can go to edit, select by attributes. You will see all the information of the file. So in this case, we'll see there's a bitmap, there's some text, there are some shapes, but we only want the information of the selection. So we select selection only. We go to the fill tab, and here we'll see all the fills of the selection, meaning we have the Pantone color and the Miami green. Okay, so we want to change the Miami green color. So we select Miami green, okay, and we can just select another color, like so. Okay. So in case of the example of the auto build, imagine you have this file, clear weld. If you send this to the cutter, know if you can see it well. If you send this to the cutter, it will cut out all the lines. So you will not have a clear result. But if you select in the cut tab, in the advanced cut tab, the auto weld option, which is now of course checked because I saved it in a preset, it will automatically cut out the globe perfectly. So it will auto weld the objects. Okay. Okay. Another tip here for colored vinyl. Yes, so I changed the color so I can see it in film mode, of course. You can set a default color for white objects, for example, make it green. It doesn't really matter what color it has, as it will just cut out the outlines, of course. And it will cut out the color which is on the machine. So this is just for visual reasons. All right. Are there other questions? I see someone is typing a question in the chat. So I have a question on the HP Latex White Series. So indeed, we will have the drivers and a version for the HP Latex 800 White Series, of course. We will first have some internal information about that. I think HP will do a webinar already. So make sure you visit the HP virtual booth. You can subscribe or register to a HP webinar for the LaTeX 800. And of course, we will have in the future, in a few weeks, some information about the driving the new HP machines with Flexi. So we will have information about that very soon. So what are the features, extra features, and so on. Okay, does anyone has questions about the webinar, about direct to final cutting, about the card templates, about the colors? Okay, very clear, perfect. Maybe one extra tip. So we have a Pantone color here. Yes, all the videos are uploaded to our YouTube page. So this is the link to our YouTube page. Here you can see all the previous webinars as well. This will be uploaded tomorrow. When tiling ketchup, can I move the tile lines? Yes, Jacob, normally if you have a bigger object than the cutter, for example, I have this one, I go to the cut plot tab, like so, one copy, and here in the tiling tab, I can move the tiling line. You can also set it with numbers, of course, and you can set an overlap as well. Like so, and if you go back, you will see the tiling changed. Horizontally as well, so we can add an extra tile, like so. And you should be able, if you deselect the options, you should be able to move the tiles individually, like so. And you will see as well the tiles. So you will have, if you want to move the lines manually, you will have to deselect the rows and the columns. So this checkbox, if they are selected like so, you can't drag the line. So you will have to first set the copies. And if you want to drag the, or to move the tile line, you will have to deselect the tiles, the columns and the rows, so you can move it like so. Okay, so I see for some, like for Stian, for example, this is very basic. I don't know, Stian, if you have a question or a more advanced question, or everything is clear. And of course, this is basic direct to final cutting examples. You can also, I can also show print and cut, a printed wrap, of course, meaning, but this depends production by production. So some do it another workflow, have other workflows to other workflows for car wrapping, but okay. So will there be an advanced webinar on point editing? For the time being now, no, there's nothing planned, but we can have a look at it. How can you align objects to a path? Christopher, okay. Which path to a guideline, for example? Christopher? Okay, for the best thing you can do, Christopher, to align objects to a path when you drag an object, and I have an object, other object, and I want to align both objects like so, the best thing you can do to make sure it's aligned well is you take the Design Central, select the first object, I have the right stationary point, select the X value, select the second one, change the point to left stationary point, and copy and paste the value here, and then we can align both objects. So now you're sure both objects are aligned to each other on the same X, Y positioning. Levi is a basic course on how to use Flexi software. I would recommend to check the YouTube channel where we have some very basic 5-minute features, 5-minute videos with some easy features. Or you can, of course, use the guidelines to align as well. If you have a guideline, you can select the guideline, select the object, and align it with the align shortcuts. I want to run objects around the circle. Christopher, maybe you can send your example to our support mailbox and we can have a look at it so we can help you individually, of course. Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed the webinar and the examples of this basic directive final job. And Lee, of course, in the we have a option for step and repeat. Go to effects, arrange, step and repeat. You will have the parts of the like so. Okay, so next time, let's see what the next month's webinar will be. You can already subscribe to it if you want. So next month, March 11, we will discuss team sticker sheets. So for Easter, team sticker sheets in Flexi, how we can make sticker sheets in Flexi. I will copy the registration URL. So copy link. Here you can already subscribe or register to the next webinar of next month. You can also visit the YouTube page, check our website for updates, of course. Voila. Hope you guys enjoyed the webinar. If you don't have questions anymore, I will end the webinar soon. I wish you all a very good day. A good health, of course, in these crazy circumstances. Keep safe, of course, Pedro. Keep healthy. And I wish you all a wonderful day. Thank you.